So far I have discussed the theory of projectile motion in the case of oblique projection. Now I am going to show you the assignment in projectiles. In this assignment in projectiles, you have mostly multiple choice questions where only one of the options is correct. And you may have also some problems without multiple choice options. At first, I am going to just read out the question and also show you each question on the screen. You go through the questions. I may give little time to try the question or think about the question. In case you need more time to answer each question, then you can take a pause after I have shown you the question and after I have read out the question. You can take a pause and then take little more time to try the problem. But I am not going to show you the solutions of all these questions immediately in the same class. So in this class and also in my next class, I will be just showing the questions one after another. Most of these questions are almost all these questions are based on the oblique projectiles, theory of oblique projectile motion. After showing all the questions in the assignment, there will be nearly 40 questions in the assignment in oblique projection. So after showing all these questions at the end of the assignment, I will be next class, that means after this class and also next class also, I will be just showing the questions. In my next class later, in my later class, I will be discussing the questions one after another, because there are various situations for different students. So out of 40 questions, one student may be exceptionally may be able to solve 35 questions or 37 questions. He may need explanation, or the student may need explanation only just for few questions. Then in that case, that particular student can skip the class on solutions of the assignment. Whereas some students may be able to answer only probably suppose 10 questions out of 40 questions. They may not be able to answer the remaining questions. So in that case, they may need solutions for most of the questions. So after showing all the questions in the assignment, I will be discussing the solutions of all the questions in the later classes. But before discussing solution, I will be showing the answers. So we can check up the answers, and in case you require the solutions, you can go through the classes for the solutions of the questions in the assignment, where you are marked the question numbers also for each class, which questions are going to be discussed in each class, which question numbers are discussed in each class. Suppose I discuss the solutions of first 15 questions in one class. In case you don't have doubts in the first 15 questions, you can skip that particular class of the meant for solution of the first 15 questions in the assignment. You can go to the next class. So, but don't get discouraged if some of the students are unable to answer most of the questions. Doesn't matter. In case some students, exceptionally, they may be weak in physics, very weak in physics, in that case, they can directly go through the class meant for the solutions of the questions in the assignment projectile, because in the class for solutions, I will be again showing each question on the screen before I discuss the solution of the question. So in the class meant for solution of the questions of the assignment, before discussing any solution of any particular question, I will be again showing you the question on the screen and then discussing it. So if you are not interested to try any one of the questions yourself first, then you can directly go to the class meant for the solutions of the questions in assignment in projectiles. But I advise the students to go through the questions in the assignment first. They let the student first try the questions on his own or on her own. So later they can go through the solutions. Come on, look at the questions one by one. I am going to show you each question on the screen, followed by four options. This is a theory question. First question is assertion reason question. The path assertion, the path followed by one projectile as observed by another projectile is a straight line. Reason. The relative velocity between two projectiles at a given place does not change with time. The correct answer is, I've shown four options here, multiple choice options. You have to select the correct answer. You have to mark the answer as one if both A and R are true. And R is the correct explanation of A. You have to mark second answer option as the answer. If you feel that both assertion reason are correct true, but other reason is not the correct explanation of assertion. You have to mark third option as answer if A is true, R is false. You have to mark fourth option as answer if A is false, R is true. Come on, start thinking about the questions. You can take a white paper or notebook. You can start marking the answers. It's not necessary for you to copy these questions on papers or notebook, because these questions will be there in the system with you. You can any time go through these questions. In case you need more time to answer any particular question, then the time given by me, you can take a pause and take your time. Next, I am going to show the next question. This is also assertion reason questions. Assertion, the body is projected obliquely at an angle theta with initial speed u. Again, I repeat, if a body is projected obliquely at an angle theta above the horizontal with initial speed u, then its speed at the instant when its velocity makes an angle alpha above the horizontal is u cos theta by cos alpha. Reason. Horizontal component of velocity projector remains constant. The correct answer is, same four multiple choice options which I have given for the previous question are again applicable for this question also. That is, I will show you the options next. First option is, if A and R are true, of course you have to mark the first option. If A, assertion A and reason R both are true, and reason is the correct explanation for assertion, you have to mark the answer as 2. If A and R are true, but R is not the correct explanation for A, you have to mark the third option as answer. If A is true, R is false, like that. So I am going to show you the options. First option, both A and R are true and R is correct explanation of A. Second option, both A and R are true, R is not correct explanation of A. Third option, A is true, R is false. Fourth option, A is false and R is true. Next, I am going to show you the third question. What is projected from the ground with initial velocity of 30 meter per second at 60 degrees to the horizontal? If J equal 10 meter per second square, the velocity of the projectile when it is at a height of 25 meters from the ground is, I am going to show you the four options. First option, 15 meter per second. Second option, 20 meter per second. Third option, 30 meter per second. Fourth option, 5 root 7 meter per second. Come on, you can take a pause and try the question. In case we require more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and take your time to try the question. It's not lengthy a problem. I'm going to show you the next question on the screen. Question number 4. Look at the question number 4 on the screen. Body is projected some angle to the horizontal. The vertical and horizontal components of its initial velocity being 60 meter per second and 80 meter per second respectively. If g equal to 10 meter per second square, then the horizontal range is, I'm showing you 4 options on screen. First option 480 meters, second option 1080 meters, third option 960 meters, fourth option 96 meters. Come on, try the question. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and try the question yourself. In case you need more time to try the problem, you can take a pause and take your time. This problem is also not a very lengthy problem. I'm going to show you the next question, question number 5. The minimum velocity of a projectile required to hit a target 125 meters away is, I have shown you 4 options on the screen. You have to mark one of these options as answer. Come on, start trying the question. You have to take g as 9.8 meter per second square for this question. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and try the question. Try the next question. Two bodies are projected with the same initial speed. One body is projected at an angle of 30 degrees and the other at an angle of 60 degrees to the horizontal. The rate of the maximum height reached is, I have shown the 4 options on the screen. Come on, try the question. This question was given originally in the 1995 MCET, the medical entrance. Come on, try the question. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and try the question. Would like to show the next question on the screen. See the question number 4. Question number 7. Not the question number 4, question number 7. We'll read out the question. 4 bodies, capital P, comma, capital Q, comma, capital R and S are projected with equal initial speeds, having angles of projection. Having angles of projections 15 degrees, 30 degrees, 45 degrees, and 60 degrees with horizontal respectively. The body having shortest range is, I have given the 4 options on the screen. You have to select the correct option. Come on, try the question. This question was also given one of the previous MCET exam papers in 2000 MCET, I think, in the engineering entrance. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and try the question. I'd like to show you the next question on the screen. A stone is thrown at an angle theta to the horizontal, reaches a maximum height h. The time of flight of the stone is, you're given 4 options on the screen. Come on, try the question. This question was also given in one of the previous MCET exam papers in the medical entrance, 1998, I think. Sometimes the year may be slightly, may be different 1 year, that's to the above or below. But the questions which were given in the entrance examinations, I am specifically mentioning, In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and take your time required for you. See the question number 9. Two stones are projected at the same speed, but making different angles with the horizontal. Their horizontal ranges are equal. The angle of projection of one is pi by 3. Of course, the angle is in radian. The maximum height reached by it is 102 meters. The maximum height reached by the other in meters is shown you the 4 options on screen. Come on, try this question. This question was also given one of the previous MCET examinations in the medical entrance, I think in 2003 medical. Come on, try the question. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and try the question yourself. See the question number 10. The equations of motion of a projectile are given by x equal to 36 t meters and 2y equal to 96 t minus 9.8 t square meters, where small t is time in seconds. The angle of projection is, they are given 4 options here. Come on, try the question. This question was given one of the previous MCET examinations in the engineering entrance. I think it was given in 2003. Come on, try the question. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and try the question. The angle of projection. See the question number 11. The angle of projection of projectile for which the horizontal range and maximum height are equal is given 4 options on screen. Come on, try it. This question was also given the previous MCET of the previous MCET examinations in the medical entrance. Come on, try to do it, answer it. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and try the question. I'd like to show you the next question then. Question number 12. The speed of a projectile at its maximum height is root 3 by 2 times its initial speed. The range of the projectile is P times the maximum height attained by it. Then P equal to dash. Come on, try the question. This question was also given one of the previous MCET examinations in the engineering entrance. So in case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and try the question. I'd like to show you the next question on the screen. Question number 13. For a projectile, the numerical value of ratio of maximum height reached to the square of flight time is, so take g as 10 meter per second square. Come on, answer the question. Even this question was given one of the previous entrance examinations. I have not mentioned on the screen, but it was given one of the previous entrance examinations in the medical entrance, I think, and MCET. Come on, try the question. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and take more time. See the next question. See the question number 14. A stone projected with a velocity u at an angle theta with the horizontal reaches a maximum height h1. When it is projected with velocity u at an angle pi by 2 minus theta with the horizontal, reaches the maximum height h2. The relation between the horizontal range r of the projectile, comma h1 and h2 is shown you the four options. In each option, express range in terms of h1 and h2. You have to find out the, which option is correct. Come on, try to answer the question. This question comes from one of special cases which I have already discussed. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and try the question. I'd like to show you the next question on screen. Question number 15. Four bodies are projected with the same initial speed at angles 25 degrees, 35 degrees, 45 degrees, comma 70 degrees to the horizontal. Their horizontal ranges are r1, r2, r3 and r4 respectively. The correct ascending order is come on, try the question. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and take more time to answer the question. I'd like to show the next question on screen. 16th one. Which of the following statements are correct for a body projected obliquely at some angle to the horizontal at the highest point? I'm going to show you four options. Four statements. Statement A, velocity is perpendicular to acceleration. Statement B, vertical component of velocity is 0. Statement C, horizontal component of acceleration is 0. Statement D, speed is minimum. Here more than one of the statements may be correct. You have to select all the correct statements. Come on, try the question. Try to go through the question. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and take your time. Show you the options for this question. But mark only first option as the answer. Only A and B are correct. To mark second option as the answer. If A, B, C are correct, you have to mark third option as the answer. If all the four statements A, B, C, D are correct, you have to mark the fourth option as your answer. If only B and D are correct. I'd like to show you the next question on the screen. That is question number 17. Two bodies of masses M and 4M are projected at angle 60 degrees and 5 with the vertical such that they stay in air for same time. Then the ratio of the maximum height reached by them is given four options on the screen. Come on, try the question. This question was given in 1988 MCET examination, commonly both for medical and engineering. This problem also comes under one of special cases. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and take your time. See the question number 18. Two bodies are projected at angle 30 degrees and 60 degrees to the horizontal from the ground so that the maximum height reached by them are equal. Then, first statement, their times of flight are equal. Second statement, their horizontal ranges are equal. Third statement, rate of their initial speeds of projection is root 3 is to 1. Four statements, both take same time to reach the maximum height. Here more than one of the statements may be correct. I will show you the options next. Next, I am going to show you the question number 18. Two bodies are projected at angles 30 degrees and 60 degrees to the orientator from the ground, such that the maximum heights reached by them are equal. Then I am going to show you the four statements here. Statement A, their times of flight are equal. Statement B, their orientator ranges are equal. Statement C, the ratio of their initial speeds of projection is root 3:1. Statement D, both take same time to reach the maximum height. Come on, try to answer the question. Here more than one of the statements may be correct. The next, I am going to show you the four multiple choice options for this question, indicating the statements which are correct. This question comes under the one of the special cases in oblique projection I discussed in earlier class. Come on, try to answer the question. In case you need more time, you can take a pause and take more time to answer the question. I will show the options. Mark the answer as 1 if A, B, C, D, all the four statements are correct. Mark the second half of the answer if A and B, C are correct. Mark the third half of the answer if A and C are correct. You have to mark the fourth half of the answer if A, C and D are correct. Next, I am going to show you the question number 19 on the screen. A body is projected with initial speed of 100 into root 3 meter per second in an angle of 60 degrees above the horizontal, v equal to 10 meter per second square, and the velocity of the projectile. Here also I am going to show you the question number 19. A body is projected with an initial speed of 100 into root 3 meter per second. That's 100 into root 3 meter per second. An angle of 60 degrees above the horizontal. J equal 10 meter per second square. And the velocity of the projectile. I am going to show you four statements A, B, C, D, out of which more than one of the statements may be correct. Statement A is perpendicular to its acceleration at the instant t equal to 15 seconds. Statement B is perpendicular to the velocity of the projectile is perpendicular to the initial velocity of projection at t equal to 20 seconds. Statement C, velocity of the projectile is minimum at the highest point. Statement D, velocity of projectile changes both in magnitude and direction. Come on, try the question. Here more than one of the four statements A, B, C, D may be correct. You have to find out all the statements which are correct. In case you require more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and take more time. You have to mark the first option as answer if the statements A, B, C, D are correct. You have to mark the second option as answer if the statements A, C and D are correct. You have to mark the third option as answer if the statements B, C, D are correct. Have to mark the fourth option answer if the statements A, B and D are correct. So next I am going to show you the next question. Question number 20. A stone is projected from the ground with a velocity of 50 meter per second at an angle of 30 degrees to the horizontal crosses the wall after 4 seconds. The distance beyond the wall at which the stone strikes the ground is so look at the question number 20 here next. Stone is projected from the ground with a velocity of 50 meter per second at an angle of 30 degrees to the horizontal. It crosses a wall after 4 seconds. The distance beyond the wall at which the stone strikes the ground is. So I have shown the four options on the screen. You have to select one of them. You have to take g as 10 meter per second square. Come on, try the question. In case you need more time to try the question, you can take a pause and take your time. Would like to show the next question on the screen. Question number 21. Particle projected from the level ground just clears in its ascent a wall 30 meter high and 120 into root 3 meter away measured horizontally. The time from projection to clearing the wall is 2 seconds. How far from the wall does it strike the ground on the other side of the wall? The level of the ground is the same on both sides of the wall. G equal 10 meter per second scale. Come on, try the question. Come on, try the question. So in case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and take your time to answer the question. Take more time to answer the question. I'd like to show the multiple choice options on the screen. First option 115 into root 3 meter. Second option 180 into root 3 meter. Third option 120 into root 3 meter. Fourth option 210 into root 3 meter. See the next question, question number 22. A particle is projected with a speed u, the angle theta with the horizontal, and it moves under gravity. During its ascent, it reaches a point P, where its velocity makes an angle alpha with the horizontal. The typical component velocity at point P is, there are four options here. Which are shown on the screen, out of which only one option is correct. You have to select the correct one. Come on, try the question. In case you need more time to answer this question, you can take a pause and take your time, but anyhow you should not require much time for to answer this question. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and try the question. See the question number 23. An object is projected with a velocity of 20 meter per second. Make an angle of 45 degrees with the horizontal. The equation for the trajectory is y equal to ax minus bx square, where y is the height and x is the horizontal distance. E and b are constants. The ratio a is to b is. Come on, try the question. This question was originally given 2001 MCET exam in the engineering entrance. Come on, try the question. So in case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and take your time to answer the question. See the question number 24 on the screen. The body is projected at an angle of 37 degrees with horizontal to have a range of 60 meters. The height of vertical wall at horizontal distance of 20 meters from the point of projection that can be just cleared is. I have shown four options on screen. Come on, try this question. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and take more time to answer the question. See the question number 25. A bomber flying upwards at an angle of 53 degrees with the vertical releases a bomb at an altitude of 800 meters. The bomb strikes the ground 20 seconds after its release. J equal to 10 meter per second square and sine 37 degrees equal to 0.6. And the velocity of the bomber at the time of release of the bomb is. I have shown four options on the screen. Come on, try the question. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and try the question. See the question number 26. Particle is projected with a velocity of 20 meters per second so that it just clears two walls of equal height 10 meters which are at a distance 20 meters from each other. The time interval for which the particle travels between these two walls is. I have given four options on screen. Come on, try the question. You have to take G as 10 meters per second square. In case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and try this question. So the question number 27, a particle is aimed at a mark which is in the same horizontal plane as that of point of projection. It falls 10 meters short of the target when it is projected at an angle of 75 degrees. It falls 10 meters ahead of the target when it is projected with an elevation of 45 degrees. The angle of projection for which a particle exactly hits this target is. So I have shown the multiple choice options on the screen. Come on, try this question. So in case you need more time to answer the question, you can take a pause and try, take your time and try the question. See the question number 28. Body projected with an initial velocity at an angle theta to the horizontal reaches a point P 2 seconds after projection. And 6 seconds more, it returns to the horizontal plane through the point of projection. The maximum height reached by it is. Four options are shown on the screen. Come on, try this question. You have to take G as 9.8 meter per second square. So in case you need more time to answer the question, can take a pause and take more time, the required time for you. I'd like to show the next question. See the question number 29 on the screen. The horizontal range of a projectile is twice the maximum height reached by it at the instant when it reaches the highest point of its path. The angle between its velocity vector and the position vector with respect to the point of projection of the origin is. I have given four options on the screen. Come on, try this question. So, in case you require more time to answer the question, can take a pause and take your time to answer the question. So, question number 30, shot fired at an angle theta equal to tan inverse 1/5 above the horizontal, strikes horizontal at the top of tower, 260 meter high, j equal 9.8 meter per second square, then find the magnitude of initial velocity of the shot. Come on, try the question. So you try these questions. In my next class, I will be showing the answers for these questions.